Let's look at my home as a case study for energy conservation and appropriate technologies. I think you will find it to be a nice example of the permaculture principle, apply self-regulation and accept feedback. The design for my home is based in the fact that energy is a limiting factor in the future. We can minimize the impacts by practicing conservation. With conservation as the primary driver, we hope to match the energy that we need to use with what we are able to generate. Our home was a flat-roofed home when we purchased it, which is interesting since we live in Portland, a climate that receives an ample amount of rainfall 9 months of the year. Originally, our flat roof diverted the rainfall through a pipe to the storm drain. We wanted to use the rainfall to hydrate our site. Catching and storing the rainfall became a top priority. First, my partner and I wanted to store the rainfall in the soil through a carbon-rich landscape. The soil is the cheapest and best place to store water. We began our garden install with a 10-yard dump of composted organic cow manure and 1 ton of straw bales. This worked out well in the long run. Now my soil feels like chocolate cake, and I water the garden about every 3 days in our dry Oregon summers. Adding lots of organic matter and carbon on the front end led to good water retention in the garden. We replaced our roof and reinforced the walls of our home to make it structurally sound for a green roof. We added a 3,000-gallon rainwater catchment tank on the north side of our house. Since we have a long dry season in the summer, the 3,000 gallons of water that we collect in the cistern only lasts until July. We tend to refill the cistern with city water in case of emergency and to give us the ability to run two hoses at the same time when watering the garden. When we reinforced the walls and replaced the roof, we insulated our home on the roof, walls, and in the crawl space. Zane took care to make sure that there was minimal thermal bridging. Now our home is like a beer cooler in the summer and warm in the winter with minimal heating. We replaced the roof. To minimize shifting temperatures inside the home by air escaping, we took down the fireplace. Next, we needed to decide on a heat source for our home. We contemplated heating with wood or biomass, or adding solar panels to the roof. Since we live in a city, we felt that we needed to go with solar to prevent poor air quality in the neighborhood that could come from an inversion in the valley and the smoke from wood stoves. In addition, it's difficult to have the storage space for wood on an urban lot. Our solar panels are tied to the grid. As we replaced the electrical and the plumbing, we took every opportunity to conserve energy. Our water heater is close to the shower, lessening heat loss as the water travels through the pipes. We put the water heater on a switch that I turn on about a half hour before I shower. By not having the hot water heater on all the time, we save energy. There's always extra hot water for dishes and other needs within a day of showering. My office moved from the northwest side of our home to the south side of the house. The north side of a home tends to be darker than the south side. Now I have nice natural light when I work, now that my office is on the south side of the house. The area for starting seeds for our plant nursery is in my office. We have 4 T5 bulbs that provide light for the plants. Even though we put in a heat pump as our heat source, the lights are pretty much all we need now for heating our home. This speaks of the fine insulation job. We don't have a washing machine or a dryer at our home, but we use the washer hookup inside for the hose to water the indoor nursery. In the future, we have the option to get a washing machine if we choose. Most of my clothes need hand washing anyway. I tend to wear wool and silk, which are good fabrics for keeping you warm in the winter and cooler in the summer. Since we grow our own food year-round, we opted not to have a refrigerator. I do a lot of food preservation, including canning, fermentation, dehydration, and we have a freezer for berries, meat, and pesto. A small cooler provides the wee bit of refrigeration that we need, mostly for dairy. On the east side of our home, we have a nice patio cover that helps to keep the house cool in the summer. Our clothesline is under the patio cover, preventing my clothes from discoloring in the sun. On the west side of our home, we have a large sweet gum tree that blocks the heat of the sun in the summer. It loses its leaves in the fall, allowing light to reach our home in the winter. One unique feature that we have in our landscape is our biogas digester. This is an anaerobic composting system that produces methane gas to run a cook stove. It also lets out a liquid that can be used as fertilizer. Would you like some coffee?